Hi, in this screencast, we'll see the virtual host in Tomcat server. Virtual host in Tomcat. Here we can set up the many websites hosted into single Tomcat. So the websites, each website have each own domain name. So the all domain names entries are pointing to the single Tomcat. Suppose in this screencast, we'll set up the one three sample websites, ramki.com, krishnan.com and blog.ramki.com. Now this is my outline. We have one Tomcat server. The Tomcat server IP is 1.15. Now in the Tomcat have three websites: Ramki site web apps, Krishnan site, and blog.ramki sites. Each web app have, it's like a same web apps in where Tomcat provide the default web apps. So they have many context. Now anyone from outside through browser, they access the ramki.com or krishnan.com or blog.ramki.com. All the requests are processed by the single Tomcat. This Tomcat can identify the request and the process accordingly. Suppose somebody asking the ramki.com, then he the go into the process this folder and which context they asking, that particular context is processed. Krishnan.com in automatically take the Krishnan site web apps and they processed. Now we'll go first see the server.xml layouts. It's a virtual host is an inbuilt functionality for the Tomcat server. So first we'll see the server.xml layout. Okay, now we'll see the configuration folder. Check the server.xml. Okay, here is the server tag. Inside the server tag is serviced service. The Catalina service is there. Inside the Catalina service, Catalina engine is there. Inside the Catalina engine, there is a host is available. Now let's see here. This is your server tag. Inside the server tags, many entries, but we need to concentrate in service. Inside the service, we have the engine. Inside the engine, the host is there. Host is, they mentioned that the local host. So that's why when your server is started, this Tomcat server started, when you type the local host, it's automatically identified, and this is web apps. Web app folder will provided here. This web app folder. So automatically take this web apps, and what are the context we asking, that particular context is served. Now what we need to do, we need to add some more entries, more host entries in that server.xml file, like this host name www.ramki.com, application spaces, and we need to create a new app application base and provide like this Ramki web apps, like that another two for Krishnan and blog.ramki.com. Now we need to add the host entries. So copy the one host entry and complete this host. Now we paste the host. So we need three websites, so three hosts is placed, and the end just end the tags. Now instead of host name localhost, type www.ramki.com. .krishnan.com blog.ramki.com. Here web apps. Here web apps is the default local host pointed to this web apps. But our each website to point to different web apps. So we need to create a new web apps. Ramki web app, Krishnan web app, and blog web apps. You can put any name and save the file and come to outside in the Tomcat. There is a one web app is there. We need to copy the these web apps and paste it and change the name to each one we specified in the server.xml. So Ramki and those web apps. Underscore web apps and blog underscore web apps. This is no need. Then now the host is we already added. Now we go for DNS entries. Actually, now when you type the browser ramki.com, the browser asking to the DNS server and get the IP address. if you deployed in outside world, then you need to purchase the domain name like this ramki.com, krishan.com, and we need to update the DNS entry. All are pointing to the same address. That's when where the our virtual Tomcat server is placed. But we are not purchasing here. We so we can simulate this DNS entries in. Ramki.com. Add same copy and paste the entries. Krishan.com and blog.ramki.com. So here we I added three domain names. That's me Ramki.com, Krishan.com, and blog.ramki.com. All are pointing to the same IP address where the Tomcat is actually installed. Then save the file. Okay, here we have three web apps. One is blog web apps, Krishan, and Ramki web apps. But all are in inside is all are same. So instead of that, I am showing some differences. So in blog.web apps, I am going to copy the documents and paste it into the root. So I clear the root, delete it, and paste the docs. So when you use this web apps folder, you can see the doc files, documentation files. Now in Ramki web apps, I'll clear the root files and I pasted some manager files, so I pasted here. In Krishan, we delete it and I pasted all the example files. Start the Tomcat. Downloads. Now Tomcats are started. Now check it. Lock the post. 80. Okay, now Tomcat is started. Now see like this. www.tomcat.com. Actually port number is 80. Now our Tomcat is not running in 80 port, so we need to mention the 8080. Actually we are putting manager request. The manager files are putting into root, so the manager is starting directly. Suppose running www.krishan.com. Same 8080. You will see all the example files. Suppose www.blog.ramki.com 8080. You will get the documentation files. So now all are running in single Tomcat, but based on the DNS entries, we will get the different site informations. Okay. Now let's see how it's this virtual hosting is working. Actually, when you request any request, there is a request HTTP header is there. In the HTTP header, there is a one host field is there. So Tomcat intercept the host field and check the what they written in host field. Host field usually have the domain name. So Tomcat check that this domain name with our host tag file in the server.xml as previous like this. Suppose ramki.com is matched here, then this application base is used and application base is used. If it's matched, Tomcat point to corresponding application base and process the request. It's going next level. Suppose this is a HTTP header. When you ask the ramki.com, this is a field is coming. Let's see here. Okay, here is blog.ramki.com. It's working. Now we'll intercept with the Firebug. So go to the Firebug, click net, and now recheck that one. That means refresh the page. Now we'll get the first request is blog.ramki.com. When you extend this one, and here this is request. When you see the request header like this here, view source, when you see that this is the actual request raw data, when you see here host, host is the trunk pointing to the blog.tomcat.com. So Apache, sorry, Tomcat server intercept this request and manually check with this XML file, server.xml file, and they understand which application basis we are used. So the based on that, our request is served. Suppose this is setups. Suppose one tomcat.com request comes to the Tomcat. The Tomcat and read this, intercept this request, and check with the server.xml, and they find out that the first folder, which Tomcat web apps folder is matched that one. So here there is a lots of context is there. Which context the request is asking, that particular context is executed, and the process the request is served. Thank you.